Okay, I think it started just because full screen recording is a little bit different, you know, because it doesn't, for example, lag for a second to basically let me know that it started, you know. So maybe that actually will help, so these like little lags wouldn't appear. But yeah, anyway, let's continue. Also, yeah, if you may hear some sounds or something, that's because I opened basically balcony, so yeah, just so you know. The paved road continued even as we headed into the mountains. The slope was steep, probably about a 20-degree incline. Being a cyclist made me extra sensitive to these things. Small trees covered the sides of the roads, but I didn't know what species they were. Dad?
Just a little bit of Fukigami-kun is pretty good.
No, it's not fair to compare the stamina of guys and girls.
That's a problem.
She had made a comment earlier about how it was harder to move in a rough coat and had taken it off. Do you know what those trees are?
Probably mikan, deshō. Kono atari mikan no kazuen ga hirogatteiru to mae ni oji ni kiita oboe ga aru. Demo mou hōki sareteiru no kamoshirenai. Rei ni yotte atotsugi ga inai mitaina koto mo itteita kara.
So most likely they go into the place where no one lives. And that could be used by Kira. Oh, okay. Makes sense. If the bollocks around there also. I looked around and indeed the area didn't at all look like it was being well kept. The paved road indicated there should have been some sort of traffic, but we had yet to see a single person. We were walking along such a desolate and lonely pass. Right. Why do you want to capture Borok? I waited for a while, but received no answer. Oh. Is it around here? It's like I didn't know the exact destination, so I hoped we would pass it by, but if I imagine to distract her, or if I manage to distract her. However!
Ara? Kono tatemono?
Right. The only buildings we've seen so far were prefab huts, but this was an actual house. Right. So we cracked along the exterior walls and Viz had overtaken the porch. It didn't look like anyone was living in it. Right.
Oh! Mita!
I thought he didn't show his emotions on his face, but okay. Let out a sigh. I saw it, did you?
Eh. 距離的にも大体この辺で合っている. ソナーで示されていたのはまさにこの家なんだわ.
I couldn't feign ignorance anymore. I checked the sonar again. Damn, this is pretty crazy.
何が?
There are a lot of them there. I can tell when better at this range. I'm not lying, look. Right. I returned the sword to my pocket. I think we should head back, turn back Arisaka. I regarded her with a serious expression, but she only returned a close glance. It's not that dangerous to pass by them in town, but this building is no joke. I looked at the single-story house again. I wouldn't want to get anywhere near it, even if I didn't know what Lurgan said. It just had that kind of aura about it. Borok's only assemble in dangerous places. You know that as well as I do, right?
Ma.
I guess you kind of have no choice right now. See, the sky itself is telling us to turn back. Right, that was pretty stupid. It seems she had me read like a book. Had me read, maybe. No? Not about you? Was it fate that was pushing us to go inside into this house? This time I thought of it almost seriously. Alright. I came out this way, might as well stick to the end. Both of us gasped as soon as we stepped inside. I expected this, yet the chills still ran across my skin. Right. Although they had no eyes, noses, or ears, the Borg still somehow reacted to us. Nisaka clutched my hand surprisingly tightly. Like in dreams, there was nothing we could do to fight them here. Kirito's grandfather had once told me why.
Boda hawa iwaba minamo ni utsutta kage no yō na mono nanda na. Kage o utsukesou to shite minamo o tsuyoku tataita to suru darō. Sono shunkan wa ōkiku nami utte kage no sugata mo mie naku naru. Da ga moto ni modoreba masani moto no moku ami da.
Okay, apparently that didn't help, as you saw. Or heard, or whatever.
相手を叩いたつもりで、 その実、叩いているのは水面に過ぎんのだ。 そのことを忘れんようにして、 無駄な接触は控えることだな。
Brook stopped just a few centimeters away from Isaka's face, and as though having lost interest, turned around. I didn't know if interest was a bit too human-like of an expression for those things. All the other Borgs had they turned to us as we stepped in. They too resumed shuffling around, minding their own business. I actually wanted to say that place looks fine, but yeah, I guess it's kind of... I mean, it looks alright, but not like, you know. Yeah. This was even worse than what we found in Forza. No, may happen. In fact, I still held my arm. What the fuck with you people? No, not being good with horrors and like doing this shit. Like, what the fuck are you two doing? Like, you in Korea? Like, what? Right. In fact, I stayed with your hands catching my arm as though having just noticed it now. I thought she like. Told it like a few seconds ago, no? I don't mind. She quickly produced a perfectly normal looking glass bottle from her bag. What's this? How exactly? Really? Is that even possible? Okay, fair enough. But there's... you basically... relying on the words... on the words of person who didn't even see them once, like... So, like... No? Yeah, he told me. I mean, they can, like... practically travel through anything, like through cracks and stuff, so yeah, okay, that makes sense that they could, you know... be placed in bottle. But how? And second, only toward one of the bodies with your chin. I mean, yeah. That's here. Yeah, that makes sense. That was the impression I got in Forza too. They move like a swarm of insects, which means they like insects by its physics. But are you sure you can stuff it into such a small bottle? Right, Kirito mentioned Risaka was completely convinced your plan would work. Wait, can we investigate this house first a little? There's got to be something in this place given the number of bottles here. You said that yourself just earlier.
Thanks.
I felt like I just followed her out of my own volition, but if that was how she took it, all the better. I looked around the foyer again. Products blocked my field of vision, but I could still the place was completely run down. Right. That kinda was close. The rain that I thought would let upright away grew even stronger.
私は奥の寝室を探るわ。
Yeah. Marks party to the side of like water as we move towards them. The insects form like motions made my skin crawl. The rooms themselves were huge, but the house seemed to only have a combined kitchen and dining room and a bedroom. The place looked run down, but it had all the typical necessities lying around. It was as though the inhabitants had just simply disappeared. I checked the kitchen first and realized there was almost no dust on the floor. So someone is living here. What about the other places? Like the table? The table was covered by a thick layer of dust. And it was the same for the kitchen cabinets. Okay, it seems that only the path leading to the bedroom looked like it had been recently used. Alright. What is it? I moved to the bedroom in front of Isaka, looking into a drawer of the on the desk. Your face pale? Huh? I peeked inside, but couldn't quite understand what it was at first sight. They were flat, about 10 centimeters long. It almost looked like some sort of tool. The drawer was stuffed with these things. I reached in with the tip of my finger. I didn't know what they were, but I felt it would be unwise to try to touch them. The objects themselves were a dirty looking brown and had an odor about them. I thought those were tools of some sort, but it seemed like I misunderstood. All of the sizes and shapes differed, so they couldn't be a manufactured product. Actually, they kind of look like... Are those ears? Wasn't that Joker guy doing that? I don't remember. My skin grew cold before suddenly flaring up. I forgot I didn't want to touch them and stuck my hand in the drawer. Smear but different when you looked at them up close. Just like people, no one had the same face, even if some could have looked similar.
So I remember.
The murder videos that appeared in Kirito's household mailbox every now and then. All the victims in them had their ears removed. Makes sense. I returned the drawer back to its position and wondered what would be the wisest course of action right now. About relying on the police for change? Yes, weren't enough to prove a murder, but they still indicated serious crime of some sort happens. Right! The sound of those opening reached us from the main room. If Saga says why not so much that I was worried they might have popped out. We went in the dream right now, we had no piles here. I quickly looked around the room but only noticed an old closet in the corner. The windows were locked and we couldn't return to the main room. There was no escape. I put the Saga's hand without saying a word and pushed him into the closet. Breathing sounded awfully loud in my ears. Was it really? We did just feel that way because we were trapped in a narrow space. Shit, we left the bottle on the desk! Now get it back! Yorick, what the fuck? He'll figure us out if he finds it. I mean, yeah, but... Ignoring her attempts to stop me, I opened the closet doors. I strained my ears but couldn't hear any footsteps. It looked like I still had time. I quickly moved to the desk with my eyes on the door. It was just a few minutes away, but it seemed like it took forever to reach it. What? My hands shook and the bottle slipped through my fingers, but I managed to catch it with my left hand before it struck the desk. It's like a frantically signaled me to reset. I closed the bottle to my chest as not to drop it again and quietly hurried back the way I came. Yeah, and they have no bottle. I mean, yeah, at this time he could have, take it with the other hand, but, you know, they could have at least do something. The moment I close the doors. The only thing I don't understand that's basically happening in the moment. You see the light? Like right here. They trying to show as if it's sunset or something. But we know for sure that it was raining and, you know, thunder, lightning and that stuff. So, like, there is a storm outside, so, like, what the fuck? There is no sun. So, like, what? Where is this guy coming from? I mean, it's just, you know, a little nitpick, maybe, but, you know, it's kind of strange. Because the sound of a footstep in, into the bedroom, I see a ray of light shone the closet through a crack in the doorway. I press my eye against it. Okay, I don't guess. The person in the room seemed to be at a blind angle from the crack at the closet, in the closet. Frustrated, I turned my head left and right, but my field of vision didn't improve. That silence continued for what felt like an eternity. Did he notice us? Was he holding his breath and looking for an opportunity to attack us? He must have been just outside the door, yet I couldn't hear a single thing. But then, I heard it. Ah, he will continue doing it. But yeah, so, yeah, that's kind of, yeah, that's kid. Yeah, that's kid. I mean, unless they have another character that will laugh, you know, with the same tone of voice as he does, well, because, yeah, because fucking reasons, and I need to be mindful of that, of course, right? It's okay, my blood had turned to a boil, only to evaporate in an instant. Monogus Q stood outside the closet door. I pressed my hand against the wooden frame, but held myself down at the last moment. I didn't care if I ended up dying in fights, if anything that was what I wanted. But I couldn't revolve in this sucker in my reckless attempt to get revenge. If I died, should most likely die too, and there was no way I could let that happen. I bit my lip with all my strength as the taste of blood trickled into my mouth. I lost my dog as I fought back the hurricane that raged in my heart. Can you see him? Can you see who it is outside the door? Aroka could move within 1 meter radius from Hiriban. And like Vodex, she wasn't bound by any physical laws. She disappeared beyond the wooden frame and quickly came back. I mean, you still can understand if this person you know or not, no? His hands? He's crying?
Yeah, there's a guy.
Is he the one that killed you? It was the one question that tore at my mind, but Madoka wasn't very confident with her reply. It was then that I realized that my arm was hurting from how hard the Risaka was clutching it. Give time for my future self. Give time to my future self, sorry. I figured it was out of fear, I didn't pay it much attention, but then I realized something else. The timer had moved. On here? What? What? The hands of the mechanism was covered with fluorescent paints, so you could see it in the dark. It albeit very slightly moved to the right. Right. I see. I look at the timer again. Only the minute hand moved. Did it mean she only had 1 minute? Suddenly, I remember that our buttocks here were attracted by the bodies. They also showed up in places where where tragedies would happen, uh-huh. Which meant that Arisaka... I look through the crack as soon as I hear his voice. George! I let out the gasp, he noticed that there was no doubt about it! A hatchet? I deadly clutched Arisaka's clothes and put her down together with myself. A shower of debris and dust landed upon us, making it nigh impossible to breathe. But if we stayed on the floor, we end up killed by the falling attack. Plus, I got to confirm his face with my own eyes. The face of the bastard that murdered Madoka. Huh? But he was already gone by the time I stood up. I stepped over the pieces of the closet and stood in the middle of the room. I turned to see Arisaka, still just as pale as before. He saved her. Then it's his turn. Don't stop me, I...
いい、今君は私を助けてくれたのよ。うん。あ?オダハに取り憑かれた私を君は助けてくれたの?この子と意味、ちっちゃんさんに聞かなかった?いや。ああ。オダハ青に取り憑かれた人間を救ってはいけない。それをするとな。うん。キャッツメは今度
I hardly checked the time again. 1 hour. 1 hour? I mean, it's not time for that, so.
I mean, okay, Madoka, you're right, but.
Wow. I shook my head, now wasn't the time to think about it, yeah. So, would I really die in just an hour's time? I couldn't quite believe it, but if I didn't do anything, Isaka would have most definitely been killed by that hatchet back then too. In the sense, we could probably trust this time, eh? As screwed up as it was. I mean, on bike? I can make it if I take my bike. As long as that wasn't stolen. We rushed out of the building and continued down the hill. The rain had abated as though it never happened. It was nothing but blue sky above us. Margo's bike was right there where I left it. Can you call the police? And if he will come back and kill you, then what? No. This is probably not a good idea. It's too dangerous, yeah. Okay, are you retarded? The house is over there. You should ask them to let you in and wait for a taxi in there. Got it? I saw her nod and stepped on the bike. I knew it and went down the hill at full speed. How's this view?
Kobin, it's no money to get to the Itanoka.
What? How does that make sense? Wasn't it closed? And if it wasn't, then like what? When Fukigami just ran out, he like closed it and took with him? Or what? How does that make sense? The water in the bottle looked like it had its mouth open and was screaming silently. She risked her life to get this, and yet her entire body shivered to the side of it. Right. I managed to make it somehow.
Oh, Shinji-kun.
Yeah, good day.
Fukigami-kun.
The two were already notified and waiting for me in front of the gate.
Okay.
I was out of breath, so it was really hard to talk. I made it, but there was little time left. According to the timer, I still had 10 minutes. The pistol is laid away on the table.
使い方は大体わかるだろう。激鉄を起こし、引き金を引く。それだけだ。Yes。シリンダーには2発を実弾と同数の空砲が込められている。それも先日見せた通りだ。Critter's
grandfather showed me the cylinder again. Two of those cylinders could kill a person. Looking at them like this made it hard to be, had to believe. Making it hard to believe, maybe not. Yeah, I guess. He picked up the revolver and handed it to me. Not even he could avoid the tension in these circumstances. I did what he said. The cylinder clicked as I stopped it, setting my fate in place. All I had to do was raise the hammer and pull the trigger. That's actually pretty fucking stupid. The reason why? Because he literally, you know, saw, you know, the police basically. And he kind of at least has an idea, right? Which could kill or which could not. So if he has a really precise sense of, you know, just sense, he could stop with, you know, bullets that he needs. So it's not about luck, it's actually just, you know, about skill. Unironically. So that's pretty strange. I was literally playing Russian roulette. Kirt entered the room, her face completely pale. Yeah, I mean, just in case. I mean, he obviously wouldn't... I mean, he obviously won't die because, oh, fucking of course, there's like second chance, but, you know. Give me a sec. I mean, she's aware of full armor. Give me a sec again. Nice. Or maybe there will be a choice. Would be cool. I press the pistol against my temple. I really like the visuals. I really like how they emphasize, you know, the colors and stuff. It's really well done, in my opinion. The cold current still made me shudder from the depths of my soul. The two regarded me with worried looks. I felt like I had died when Madoka was killed. Revenge was the only thing keeping me alive. And I finally tracked down the culprit today. No way I could die now. No hesitation. He's fucking awesome. Wait, come on. I let out a long sigh, completely emptying my lungs. And... The product jolted out of my body, let out a soundless scream, and melted into the air, disappearing.
Taskatta ka?
Yokatta.
Cold sweat broke out over my entire body. A combination of relief and exhaustion made me almost faint in the... Curtis' grandfather regarded me with a mixed expression as I handed the revolver back. Is something wrong?
Yeah,
and that's why it's suspicious, you know.
Yeah,
some people, you know, can't do it to save his life. It's quite ironic, yeah? There's some people who who basically could take their own life, you know, suicide and stuff. And the others who can't do it to save their own life. So strange, right?
Sore wa kakujitsu na shi o iimi seru kara na. Tahan ga. Kimi wa assari to higane o hiita na. Onore no atama o fuki dobasu kamoshirenai higane o.
Nani ga iitai no? だってそうでもしないと助からないのだから。
No, I don't guess.
Yeah.
Kido's gonna further just slowly shook his head.
まあ、助かってよかった。
Yeah. Huh? Big wasp suddenly appeared in the room and zipped by our ex? What? Kido's grandfather quickly opened the window and the wasp flew out.
Bikkurista!
Okay, that was... Okay, that was out of nowhere. Kido pressed his palm against his chest. Where did that wasp come from? Had it been clinging to my body since the orchid? Ah, that what would kill him! Ah! Okay. Since the orchid? It looked like it was startled by the heavy metallic sound of the gun, but... I remember something a doctor once told me. It was when I went to the hospital to get a wasp sting treated. You may have heard of anaphylactic shock. To explain it in simple terms, your body synthesizes antibodies once you get stung. It's nothing serious the first time, but the second might make your body go through a severe allergic reaction. In the worst case scenario, you might even die. I see, yeah. As such, please be extra careful from now on. And if something happens, treat it as quick as possible. The first 10 minutes are extremely important. I understand. And you two kids, make sure to stay away from bees and wasps from now. Okay. Huh. 10 minutes. He definitely said 10 minutes. I looked at the revolver on the table. If that was what chased off the wasp, a lack of hesitation might have truly saved my life.
Ore? Nii-san, その kuchibiru... どうしたの?
唇? あら、ずいぶんとひどく切ってるわね。
うん、right. Yeah, I kind of accidentally bit it when I was eating.
スルメでも食べていたのっていうくらい、思い切り噛んじゃったみたいね。
I quite know it. I couldn't possibly tell them the truth. It's like I called me some time after the incident.
昼間のことは、本当にごめんなさいね。
She told me about how things went with the police.
学生の私から言うよりは、ちっちゃんさんに頼んだ方がいいかと思って、そうしたの。それで、さっき連絡があったんだけど、警察が言うには、そんなものはなかったって。やっぱり、すごく消されてしまったんだわ。
Yeah. So, good thing you did go back. I could hear the frustration in her voice. I see.
偶然とはいえ、
I don't know about that. I almost forgot that he'd meant as much to the entirety of Sakuramori Dreamers as he did to me. Joker. Serial killer that the police were powers to stop. It's likely he would simply kill you too in such a case. We can find him again. I said it mostly to myself. Come to think of it, I suddenly thought of something. The entry second sees that this was no longer her business.
それが私の仕事とは思えないわね。
それじゃ。
Ah, yeah. My lip hurt when I ate. I only realized just how deep it was when I finally looked at it in the mirror. Just how hard did I bite it? But it would heal eventually. This pain was nothing if it helped me get closer to... get a step closer to my revenge. So? Alright. I made myself remember that day.
そんなに痛いのかなと思って。
Yeah, it stings a bit. But I'm sure it will heal by tomorrow.
うん。
舐めれば傷は良くなるって言うし。だから、唇だったら…
Can you not?
なめるだなんて、そんな…
別に、初音ちゃんが舐めてあげなさいとは言わないけれど…
Okay, you said it on purpose, so shut up. Can I hear it again? Yeah. Ah, fuck, I need to do this scene. Epilogue. Well, that was a really short chapter.
よ。
Give me a sec. Marnie, it was unusual for Kirito to arrest me in school when if it was just a greeting. Is something wrong?
じっちゃんに言われたんだけど、ふきがみくんの様子に気をつけてあげていなさいとかなんとか。でも顔つきからするとどうやら昨日のショックはもうないみたいね。
I give Kyo back your nurse. Your grandfather was probably worried about something entirely different. I wouldn't forget his expression after I pulled the trigger.
じっちゃんさんが気にしたのはそれとは別のことなんじゃないかな。
Maruka seemed to be in agreement with me.
Shinji は無茶をするから、森安と戦った時もそうだったけど。じっちゃんさんは多分そのことを心配したんじゃないかな。
Shizume called me reckless too, though she also praised me for being dependable. Mine wasn't really courage though. I just didn't care about myself that much, so I decided to be a bit more careful from now on. I gotta go now.Couldn't throw my life away before getting that down. That was why I didn't hesitate to pull the trigger. Huh? Wait, does that mean it's actually pushing me to be more reckless? Yeah, yes! I knew I wouldn't be at this. Not until Jagger was taken care of, at least. That's his view. Irisaka, yes? I don't know. Oh, yeah.
Oh! Kore wa zuibun to hisashiburi no okyakusan da na.
You're right.
どうも、こんばんは。
みんなに話があるって。
わしにもか。すると
So she decided to return, I guess.
その前に、ちゃんと謝ったの？ふきがみくんに。
謝ったわよ。彼は特に何とも言わなかったけど。
クレハちゃんに話は聞いたわよ。ずいぶん大変なことがあったそうで。
ええ、そうなんです。
ジョーカーの言葉惜しかったな。まあ、幸い無事だったのだから、それでよしとするか。
それで、話って？
ええ。私も、桜の森ドリーマーズの仲間に加えてもらえないかと思って。
なるほど。
それはもちろん。でも、どういう風の吹き回し？
そうね。
うん。
これは、吹き神くんに対する罪滅ぼしなの。
です、です。I mean, he literally saved your life, so.
関係あるの？
You retarded?
彼は今後も桜の森ドリーマーズとしてやっていくつもりなんでしょう。
I mean, yeah.
ということは、危険な目に遭うこともあるかもしれない。そんな時、もし私がいることで彼のことを救えるとしたら、それは罪滅ぼしになる。
At least, you know, if
そう思ったから。
She will be able to help in some way. This, you know, this also kind of fine, you know. So yeah.
Ha ha.一見もっともらしい理屈だが。
What are you? What are you? About the first glance? What?
何ですか理屈って。
Yeah, no, it's what the fuck.
惚れたか。
fuck off.
違う、そういうあれじゃなくてですね。私は真面目に申し訳なさと恩義を感じているわけで。
Right. Oh, I also just noticed that. Pretty cool.
まあ動機は何でもいいんじゃないかというよりそれもまた立派な動機だ。
惚れた？本当に？
なんで嫌そうなのよ。
うん、いや、自分でもよくわからないわね。
強力なライバル出現といったところね。
And I see you just don't give a fuck.
そういうマホロ君はどうなんだね。
Alright.
さあ、どうでしょうか。
今のはじっちゃんさんが勝手に言っただけ。
変な勘違いしないでほしいわね。
Alright。
ともあれ、これで夢へのダイブは3人体制ということになる。危険もそれだけ減るということだな。
ええ、そうですね。
じゃあそういうことで、早速吹上くんに電話しようかな。
Get a fucking heels out. Just like sweet tone of voice when she's. Oh my god. Okay. Like what the fuck?
あ、それは私がする。
Alright.
なんでよ。
え？Alright. Funny. Ah. So yeah, I was stupid the entire time. I just forgot about that for no apparent reason. I know, right?
それにしても話はちょっと変わるけど、吹上くんって妙に鋭いわよね。死角からジョーカーに襲われたんだけど、まるでそれが見えていたみたいに避けたの。実際その動きがなかったらやられていたところだけど。
幽霊が見えるという能力ならあるけど。
幽霊？だからあんな気味の悪い家でも平気な顔していたのかな。でも鋭いというのとは関係がないような。
今ふと思ったけど、ひょっとしてシンジ君の隣には誰か幽霊がいるのかもしれないわね。
誰かって誰？
さあそれはわからないけれど、とにかくその誰かが手助けしているっていうのはある気がするな。
なるほど。
幽霊か、さもありなんだな。
どうして？
その幽霊が手助けしているなら、その人物はシンジ君と親しい間柄だろう。だが死んでしまった。そういうことなら特進が行くのだ。彼にはどこか影があるよ。
Is it again? Nice.
ねえ、ねえってば。普段は静かなんだよね。そうしてただうずくまってるの。ねえ、何を待ってるの？どうして待ってるの？寒くないの？
No。
お腹は？
No。
だったら立たないと。立って出て行くんだよ、あのドアから。たったの6メートルじゃないか。もうそれだけも動けないんだね。ねえ、こんな風に思ったことはない？扉をくぐれば、
If I pass through the door?
別の世界が広がっている
。なぜだろう？
そこは暖かくて、
ワール
ド。お腹もいっぱいで、
Satisfying。
痛いこともない。
It sounds like heaven.
そうでもないよ。
Wonder if I can go there when I die.
それって。どういう意味？ああ、ダメだよ。ダメだ。静かにしないと。静かにして。ほら、来た。来ちゃったよ。静かにするんだ。
じゃないと、また、
あ、それ別に。
また。
ああ。Nice。Окей. Чёпта 3. Кацураги Томонари. Golden Week began. Let's go to Mibukayama for the first time in a while. I didn't feel like doing it without Madoka, but I figured I could use the exercise. I really depended on getting to Kirito's house in time that day, and so it's unlikely that kind of situation would repeat itself a lot, being already didn't hurt. And so I pedaled my way down the road, so I had forgotten how exhilarating cycling could be. We used to ride to all sorts of places together. At first we stuck to distances that wouldn't exceed 20 or 30 kilometers to and back, but soon that wasn't enough. Growing tired of places we were familiar with, we cycled as far as neighboring towns. It felt like a grand adventure to our younger selves. Above everything, we were first and foremost partners in these endeavors. It was pretty incredible how we just kept going. I could feel the strain of climbing the hill on my legs. Well, those really atrophy if you don't use them, I dressed her unconsciously, but quickly remembered I didn't have her ribbon today. I usually kept it with me, but I couldn't bring her to where I was going. I knew it down an empty road just like 3 years ago. I laid the bike on the ground and stood in front of the swamp. It was warmer now that it was May, but the mountain air still carried the chill with it. It was also when Madoka was killed. Back then, in that tepid rain, I swore that I would find the bastard that killed her. That was all that kept me going. But then something else happened, something that I couldn't just chalk up as mere delusion. Right. That. Madoka!
Shinji!
Right. That was how we met again. I could tell she was no longer human right away. I didn't understand how I knew it, but I sensed it on instinctual level. That said, I still couldn't stop myself from trying to embrace her.
Atashi, myou na mou o kugutta mitai na no.
What?
So, nantonaku, mon te wakaru nda kedo, mitame wa kimyou na obuje mitai de. So shitara, 懐かしい桜の森の町が広がっていた。でも、誰も私に気がついてくれなくて。ああ、私はやっぱり幽霊になっちゃったんだって、そう思ったものよ。でも、シンジには見えるんだね。シンジは気がついてくれた。
Then I ask her about the bastard who murdered her. Later she complains that she shouldn't have told me, but...
相手の顔は、私も見ていないの。あっと思った時には、沼の中に突き飛ばされていて。だから正直、男か女か、若いか年寄りかもわからない。水の中から、確かに犯人の顔を見たはずなんだけどね。でもやっぱり水の向こうだし、あとすごく苦しかったし、だから結局顔もわからない。
ナイス。
でもね、一つだけ特徴は覚えているの。
いや、ずっとラフ。何でだよ、what kind?
笑っているような、泣いているような、言葉にするとそういう感じなんだけど、
Madoka tried to make an impression, but I didn't get it all. At least not until I actually heard a pervert and looked that rough that way. That wasn't exactly concrete evidence, of course. But this was information I heard from the actual victim that wasn't even available to the police. I knew more than them. This solidified my quest for revenge. But Madoka regretted it. I knew how she felt. But I simply couldn't forget it. Kirito messaged me after I got back from the mountains when I headed to an Italian restaurant. Hello?
Konnichiwa.
Domo.
Nerisaga?
Watashi mo Sakura no Mori Dreamers ni modotte kita no yo. Sono hanashi denwa de shita wa yo ne.
No, I was just taken aback by your rap calls. Alright.
Takui ga dou ka shita?
Everything is fine.
Ima wa bukatsu no saichuu demo nai shi. Somosomo soto da shi. Sore de odoroita nde sho?
Aa.
Mifuyu no kawarimono da kara.
Alright.
Kureha ni dake wa yowareta kunai wa ne. いいと思うけどね、 白衣 ソースかなんかをこぼしても 服が汚れなくて済むし
そういう問題?
Just exit. Shut up. Maruka stood in front of the table as I sat down.
すごいな 女子ばっかり しかもみんな揃って美人ね そんな中に男子一人で混じっていると
結構目立つよ。 Would you like to make any order? One iced coffee, please. Right away, sir. I thought of everyone as my comrades in arms, so I didn't feel that out of place. Though it must have been quite the sight for someone who didn't know any better.
悪いわね、急に呼び出して。
That's fine. I'm sorry for being late.
どこか出かけていたの?
I figured I'd do some cycling today. I said it's kind of mind-boggling that this became another Italian accent.
So, 今はトラットリア桜の森. オーナーはもちろん全くの無関係の人だけどね.
The dining area was packed just like Forza had been during its early days. And there was no bodox inside. I'm impressed they managed to rent out the place after all that had happened. I lowered my voice.
そのせいかメニューの値段がますますお安くなって学生にも優しいお店になったわよ。そうね。それでいてどれも美味しいし。本当本当。
The girls seem to be eating a cake of sorts. So what did you want to talk about? Need something to peer again? I give them a serious look.
ああ、いえ。今日は仕事の話ではなくて。 君が入って、みふゆも復帰して、桜の森ドリーマーズもだいぶ賑やかさを取り戻したでしょ?そこで一度、親睦を深めるために、みんなでどこかに遊びに出かけたらどうかなと思って。ん?あ、すごい!デートじゃん!デート?
Madoka! That was a lesson, Madoka, but my remark ended up sounding wrong than I thought. Everyone blushed slightly and fell silent as Mutu was getting kind of awkward. You got this! Yes!
Yeah. 違うような…
I'm sorry about that. Anyway, where are you planning to go?
さっきまで3人で話していたんだけど、やっぱり遊園地とか?
I don't mind.
じゃあ決まりね。急だけど、明日とかは?
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you for waiting. I have one iced coffee. I took a sip of my drink and opened my mouth again. Would it be okay if I also took Hatsune? My little sister with me.
もちろん。じゃあ明日はみんなで遊園地ね。楽しみ。私も遊園地なんか久しぶりだわ。けど、 そういえば美冬ちゃん、遊園地とか好きだった？人混みは好きじゃないみたいなことは言っていたと思うけど。
No, now she has a reason to like it.
いえ、別に。まあ、みんなと一緒なら気にならないですし。
Right. Right. Right.
そうね。美冬っていつも一人でいるし、絵を描くときも一人だし。
Also, I just... What the fuck? Was I blind? Not blind, but deaf this whole time? Give me an actual fucking second. Sakura no Mori Dreamers, right? Do I have... Yeah, I have when the bay opens. I just... Is Kureha за нами с voice actors? Voice actors. Because I just fucking realized that of nowhere that she sounds super similar, no? Am I fucking stupid or not? Give me a second. No, I don't see. Ah, yeah! Jesus, Nanaru, like, what the f- Wow, what took me so long? Or did I say that last time? Or not last time, but... Did I mention it at all? I don't remember. Like, what the fuck? How could I not? What the fuck? What? Like, what? How did I... some of you may be confused, but... well, Senkaku Rinai, that's another visual novel, and Nanaru, well... Komori Nanaru, basically, that's her full name. She was my favorite heroine in this game, and I just like fucking realizing that, yeah, that's her fucking voice actress. Like, what the fuck? What? Why am I so stupid? I mean, it sounds like really the same, no? Yeah, just calm. Yeah, this she, you know, this kind of shit. And, like, what the fuck? What? Why? Why? Sorry. I guess maybe, yeah, because she mostly calm, because Nanaru was pretty wild sometimes, and she was like this, no, pretty, how to say, really energetic character, so to speak, so yeah, maybe that's, but how the f- Of course. Well, I wanted to say absolutely, but no, okay.
Hem.
どこがよ。
まあ着物でもいいけど動きにくいんじゃないの。あとアトラクションも乗りにくいかもしれない、
そうね、それはあるかもしれないわね。あと白衣も。
Alright.
え、なんでですか。
長い裾がはためいたり、果ては車輪に巻き込まれたりとか。まあ、いずれにしろ遊園地にまで白衣を着ていくのはどうかなと個人的には思うけどね。
Right.
木上くんはどう思う？
I mean, I'm perfectly fine with it. I didn't expect them to address me, so my mind went blank for a second. Well, rough clothes are like first clothes, and we're going to amusement park to play around and relax, so...Right.
シンジ君が言うと素直にうなずくのね。
Right, right.
え、いいえ、そんな、そういうあれじゃないですけど。
Right.
じゃあ、私も聞くけど、着物については？
I agree with Shizume. I don't think traditional clothes are very well suited for having fun outside, especially when we're going to move around a lot.
そう。
I probably could have worded that a little bit better, as Kirito's expression clouded over.After that, we decided on time to meet and parted ways. Alright! So yeah, I'm gonna...
Yōenji? Iku iku!
Right. Okay, I'm going to... Fuck, Katsune, why you appeared and killed every motivation to stop playing? So yeah, I'm basically ending it there, I guess, because yeah, I'm gonna go with dogs. I need to eat and that kind of stuff. I'm gonna upload it basically right now and gonna set it to how's it published? Yeah, so it would be published around like 7:30 maybe. I don't know. We'll see. It depends on yeah, how long I will like eat right now. Yeah, how long it will take to upload and you know, give it names, descriptions, that kind of stuff. So yeah, I do 4 parts just because. I mean, I really want to do more, but you know. But yeah, see you next time.